The woman who inspired the Beatles' greatest hits. Since time immemorial, love has been the subject of thousands upon thousands of songs. And why not? It's inspired both kings and beggars, and everyone in between. It's no wonder why one of the world's greatest bands wrote songs and sang about love. But did you know that there's a special muse who became the inspiration of several Beatles songs? Learn more about the woman who inspired the Beatles' greatest hits. Meet the Beatles. In 1964, the Beatles were on top of the world. Their song, I Wanna Hold Your Hand, reached the top of the Billboard 100. They also crossed the pond to conquer the US, and the Americans welcomed them with open arms. They made history when they appeared on the then-popular Ed Sullivan Show, an episode marked by screaming and swooning studio fans. The episode was watched by 73 million people and remains one of the most impressive TV records more than 50 years later. The Beatles' popularity spilled over to the movies, and it wasn't long before they were approached to appear on films. They signed a 3-movie deal and made A Hard Day's Night, a movie named after their album. Predictably, the movie was a huge commercial hit, making the band that much more popular. The film would go on to win them more fans, not just in the US, but in other countries as well. It was on the set of the film where George Harrison, the band's guitarist, met the woman who would soon inspire him. One of the bit players in the film was a popular British model whose name was Patty Boyd. At just 20, Boyd had already appeared on the covers of top magazines such as Vanity Fair, Vogue, and Elle. Her look, from her hair to her miniskirts, was the most sought after during the 1960s. She epitomized the ideal British girl, with her shoulder-length hair, big beautiful eyes, and pink lipstick. When George met Patty. When Boyd was cast with other girls for A Hard Day's Night, part of their location shooting was made on a train. She was sitting on one of the carriages with the other girls when the Beatles came over to say hello. Harrison was reportedly smitten with the pretty model and cheekily asked her to marry him. Boyd was in a serious relationship at the time and naturally refused. However, Harrison was persistent and asked her out for dinner as an alternative to his marriage proposal. Within a week, Boyd broke up with her boyfriend and started dating Harrison. They first came out as a couple with their appearance together at the Garrick Club. During her relationship with Harrison, Boyd became half of one of the world's most photographed couples. She also became the envy of millions of girls who adored Harrison. The two were engaged quickly and married not long after. In 1966, Boyd became Mrs. George Harrison after exchanging vows at an Epsom registry office. Paul McCartney, the band's bassist, was best man. Patty's influence. Harrison and Boyd settled in a house that he had bought before they were married. Boyd began to play the role of a traditional wife, cooking and planning vegetarian meals for her new husband. They also shared an interest in religion. Harrison began to study Indian lifestyle practices with Boyd and started delving more deeply into Eastern mysticism. Boyd had been a model on the rise before her marriage to Harrison and even became more popular as a result. Boyd's look helped define the 60s, and she, along with her contemporaries, was instrumental in helping create the unique style of the era. Boyd was also getting offers to model but had to turn many of them down. As a married woman, she had priorities, and the fact that she was married to a very famous person didn't help. According to Boyd, people simply wanted to meet Harrison, and this made her feel insecure. She also found the model lifestyle exhausting, mainly because she was under stress due to her new image and popularity, and because there was pressure to keep women thin and keep their so-called ideal figure. Boyd also loved photography and often had her husband and the Beatles as her subjects. The intensity of their relationship must have had an effect on the band because soon, several songs came out inspired by the couple. These songs included I Need You, For You Blue, and Love You Too. However, the most impressive songs have been inspired by the Harrison-Boyd relationship would have to be Something. It was a song written by Harrison who showed his formidable talent via the melodious intro and impressive guitar solo. To this day, it remains one of the Beatles' most popular and greatest songs. Boyd said that it was about her, but Harrison, ever the quiet and mysterious Beatle, never confirmed it. Nevertheless, it is a tender song about love that showed Harrison's mainly untapped skills as a songwriter. Decline. Unfortunately for Harrison and Boyd, love didn't last forever, and by the early 70s, the spark began to wane. Harrison had begun experimenting with drugs and alcohol, and their spiritual beliefs were slowly pushing them apart. Harrison was also making things more difficult by his extramarital affairs. It was during this time when another man came into the picture. Unsurprisingly, he was another musician, and a very talented one at that. Eric Clapton was a close friend of Harrison's and often collaborated with him. The two guitarists shared a love for music, and it turned out for the same woman. Boyd was unaware of Clapton's admiration, and when he sent her a love letter, simply signed E, she was caught unawares. Harrison sensed that something was happening. At a party where Clapton approached Boyd to reveal that it was he who sent her the love letter, Harrison asked Boyd to choose between them. Boyd chose her husband. This rejection was enough to push Clapton into a deep depression. He sunk deeper into his drug use and became addicted to heroin, prompting him to stay away from making music for 3 years. Clapton's infatuation with Boyd was reportedly so intense that at one point, he even began dating Boyd's sister, Paula. It was supposed to be his way of getting close to her, and since he couldn't be with her, he likely figured that the next best thing would be her sister. Predictably, Clapton's relationship with Paula didn't last. A fool for love. Clapton's unrequited love was too much for him to bear, and he began to write songs again. One of these songs was about Boyd. Clapton hid her real name to avoid a scandal, instead calling her Layla in the eponymous song. The name was taken from a book called The Story of Layla and Magnon, a story about an obsessive and unobtainable love. Although Boyd revealed she was touched by the gesture, it didn't succeed in luring her away from Harrison. At least, not initially. In her memoir, Boyd disclosed that she had met with Clapton in secret when she was still married to Harrison. Clapton played his recording of Layla to her several times, watching her face for her reaction. He stated that she remembered feeling exasperated that people would know that the song was about her once they heard it. She was also afraid that Harrison would know that it was for her. However, she also confessed that the song did its magic and that she could no longer resist. It wasn't long before she and Clapton began an affair in secret. Clapton was quite straightforward about his feelings for Boyd. According to reports, he even confessed his love for her to Harrison. Harrison shrugged off the declaration and reportedly told Clapton that he could do whatever he liked because it didn't worry him. Love's not in vain. By 1977, even Boyd's efforts to stay with Harrison had failed. Harrison had cheated on her with Maureen Starkey, who happened to be Ringo Starr's wife. When Boyd discovered the affair, she decided she'd had enough and filed for divorce. She continued the relationship with Clapton. Eventually, he proposed, but did so through a mutual friend. The proposal occurred at a time when Boyd and Clapton's relationship was plagued by Clapton's affairs. At the time, Boyd had broken off their relationship temporarily, owing to Clapton's affair with another model who happened to be a friend of Boyd's. It was one of many that Clapton had, even when he was still with Boyd. Clapton called Boyd's friend, Rob, who turned in to call her and told her that Clapton wanted to marry her. Boyd first made sure that the model was no longer involved with Clapton before she agreed to his proposal. By 1979, they were married. Boyd's charm spelled magic for Clapton, who wrote two more iconic songs about his wife. These were Wonderful Tonight and Bell Bottom Blues. These songs, along with Layla, remain as some of rock and roll's most iconic ditties. Boyd acknowledged that the songs mean a lot to her as well, particularly Wonderful Tonight, which she said was inspired by a time when she couldn't decide what to wear for a party. She said that the song was a reminder of how wonderful things were for her and Clapton, especially during the early years of their relationship. Unfortunately, when things went bad, hearing the song was painful for her. Clapton was having problems with alcoholism by then and was being destructive. Boyd said that there were times when she wondered if she made a mistake when she left Harrison for his friend. Too much love. While their relationship was based on passionate love, Boyd and Clapton's marriage burned out quickly. Boyd couldn't handle the stress that came with her marriage to Clapton, and it didn't help that he engaged in several affairs with other women. Boyd began drinking. Soon, Clapton was drinking as heavily as she was. Before the end of the 1980s, their marriage was technically over. According to Boyd, she'd had it for the last time when Clapton had an affair with Lori Del Santo, a TV personality from Italy. She bore him a son, something that Boyd couldn't forgive him for, because she and Clapton were both trying to have a baby. At one point, Boyd even went through IVF treatment. The news of Clapton having a child with another woman hurt her terribly. Unbeknownst to Boyd, however, Clapton had another child with another woman during an earlier affair. He was secretly seeing a recording studio manager named Yvonne Kelly and got her pregnant. He and Kelly share a daughter named Ruth. In spite of his infidelities, Clapton begged Boyd to stay, and initially she agreed because she was still undergoing her second IVF treatment. However, she finally filed for divorce in 1988. Years after she and Clapton divorced, Boyd stated that Clapton's passion for her was probably based on his obsession about Harrison, whom he admired. For Boyd, she was something that Clapton had to have because she was George's. This was corroborated by Clapton in his memoir years later. He wrote that he coveted Patty for the simple reason that she was the wife of a powerful man who Clapton felt had everything he had ever wanted. He further stated that he tried hard to get Boyd out of his mind, but he couldn't. Third time lucky. Boyd did find love again, this time in the person of a man who was not a musician. In 1991, she met Rob Weston, a property manager, and began dating him. They were together for almost 25 years before they decided to get married in 2015. Clapton also remarried in 2002, tying the knot with Malia McHenry, with whom he has three children. Harrison passed away in 2001. Boyd has been asked time and again who, between Harrison and Clapton, influenced her more. Although she said it's a difficult choice, she cites Harrison as her biggest influence. She said, "He'll always stay with me."